One of the things that's showing up in the movement research and has for years is that most people, based on their brain, based on how it functions, have a preferred speed of movement. So if I ask 7 different people to do the same exercise and I were to film them, and all I've done is say, hey, I want you to make a circle with your arm. Some of them will be fairly close, but if I then have them keep going or I have them repeat it multiple times, there's a kind of a set speed that people will gravitate to, right? It's the one that they can typically control most easily, and that's awesome, but it is of limited use because if we want to challenge your brain to get better, stronger, and healthier, we want to challenge your body, we have to ask it to do something different. We are a brain-based education company, and so our focus is always on what's the long-term ramification of every single repetition that we do. Is it going to promote growth? Is it going to promote plasticity? Is it going to challenge the brain to change, to do something different? Because if so, that's probably a keeper. If not, it just means I'm spending time on something that I'm probably already pretty good at. That is a recipe for remaining relatively, you know, mediocre for most of us. So what we try to get people to do in our RFA certification, which is our level 1 coaching course, is we talk a lot about speed control, right? Kind of throttle control. You're driving a car, you have an accelerator, you're having a brake. So if you're driving along, obviously it would be insane to spend your entire life driving only 25 miles an hour, but that's how most people move. We kind of demand of our coaches that they become very, very focused on speed variations in their training. As an example, we teach in that course that there are 4 primary movement speeds that we want you to explore as a movement person, right? So if you're going to be doing something as simple as, let's say, an elbow circle or a shoulder circle, we're gonna have you work that at 4 different speeds over the course of a 1 or 2 month training cycle. The first speed is called super slow, and I name things very, very clearly. So super slow means super slow. For a shoulder circle, that means I'm gonna set my timer for 60 to 90 seconds, and in 60 to 90 seconds, I'm gonna try to complete 1 full shoulder circle. It feels like a freaking eternity when you're doing it because it's so slow. But what people will typically find is as they are moving at that speed, there will be certain ranges of motion as they're trying to create a nice circle where there will be a jump or they will start to get shaky. So super slow movements will often show you where you currently lack coordination, control, and joint mobility, range of motion in that given area. So we like to use that as an exploration of movement, an exploration of your own body. We also like to use it as a concentration drill. It takes extreme levels of executive function, which is how we focus attention. That's part of our frontal lobe, and it's something that we all need probably more of. It's a great executive function drill because it's requiring you to do something different than you want to do. The second speed is what we call standard speed. Standard speed is from 5 to 15 seconds, depending on the size of the joint and the body area. So I may spend 5 seconds to 15 seconds on a shoulder circle. I may spend a little bit longer than that, you know, if I'm doing something for my lumbar spine or thoracic spine. That's standard speed. We call it standard for a reason because that's still slower than most people want to move. Our third speed is called coordinated. For coordinated speed, when we're teaching a course, we just go, coordinated speed is a speed that you already like, right? So if you're biasing your training, which one are you going to spend the most time at? If no one tells you to do something different, you're going to do coordinated speed. So we're going to kind of typically bias you away from that one. And then we go to our fourth one, which is we call sport speed, which is in essence doing something as fast as you can so that we're working on some explosive movement with control. So those are your general 4 options. I would recommend that if you think through your mobility routine, whatever it is, work through all of your motor control exercises at these 4 different speeds. You don't have to do all 4 in every workout. You don't have to do all 4 every month, but over time, write it down and remind yourself that if you want to change your brain, you want to offer it novel and complex tasks, and one of the easiest ones to manipulate is speed. Work on that brake, work on that accelerator a little bit. It will pay off hugely in the end in terms of increasing brain activity and hopefully brain health and better movement control.